Hey everyone, so today is Sunday. We just got into the beach yesterday, my family, and it's rained all day today. So I figured I would film a video. On Friday, I got hair extensions. Finally, they're really long. Look, oof, I like can't even stand up. This is what they look like. They come all the way down to here. And so I'm really excited. They are 20 inches and my stylist cut off about that much just to shape the ends of it and layer it and stuff. So they're probably like 18 and a half inches now that they are styled and stuff. So I love them. So I wanted to do a video. This is gonna be a vlog, but it's gonna go on my beauty channel because it's a beauty topic. So, but it's basically just gonna be a vlog. I'm talking about like what the process was like, what I think about them, how to take care of them, all that stuff. I've wanted extensions for about 5 years. Senior year of prom 4 years ago, I got clip-ins, and there's a picture of it on my blog. I'm gonna put my blog link in the bottom bar if you guys wanna go look at it. And those are clip-ins, and they don't look as natural as real ones, but they kind of work if you don't wanna spend the money or the risk to your hair on real ones. Last summer, I have some videos in New York where I'm talking about it. Lollipop26 from here on YouTube, she is one of my favorite YouTubers ever. So I'm gonna put her link down there too. Go check her out if you haven't. I love her. She lives in London. She came all the way to New York to visit me for a couple of days, and we hung out and we made clip-in extensions where we went to a hair store and we bought real hair and we sewed on extension like clips ourselves, and we thought we were so cool. But in reality, those extensions were kind of not very good. And they kind of were like really bulky on my head and they fell out and stuff, so they weren't really that great. But I've wanted to get real ones for ages. My natural hair was kind of long. It was definitely getting there, but it just wouldn't grow past the point that it was at, and I was getting really frustrated with it because I wanted really long hair. So I finally just bit the bullet and got extensions, the permanent kind, and the brand is called Hair Dreams, and it is the strand by strand bonded application. So it's here, I'll show you. Like, they're like teeny tiny little plastic bonds. Like, here's one. Okay, it's like this much hair is like the whole thing, one bond. And it's like this little plastic piece. I don't know if you're really gonna be able to see that, but it's just this tiny little piece. And it's bonded with plastic right at the root. And it doesn't have any keratin in it. Keratin is bad because your hair has some keratin in it, and so it will like pull protein from it or something and end up damaging your hair. Whereas this stuff is just plastic, and what they do is they put your hair up, they like clip it up, and they put this little clip on it. It's like funny looking, it's like a little comb. They take a little section of your hair, like literally like 4 or 5 pieces of your hair, and they start at the bottom and they work their way up, and then they fuse a little bond of the hair extension, the long hair, around your natural hair, about 7 pieces of the real extension. And they melt the plastic with this little iron right at the tip, and you can kind of hear it fizzing. It's kind of weird sounding, but it only lasts a second. And then it's in your hair and it's bonded. When you want to take it out, there's this solution they pour on it, and it just melts all the plastic away and makes all the plastic leave your hair. And the extensions come out, and your hair is not supposed to be damaged at all if you take care of it, if you do it the way you're supposed to do it. And to be quite honest, there probably will be a little bit of damage to your natural hair. I did not go in this thinking, oh my gosh, like my natural hair will be exactly like it was when I get my extensions out. I realize they're damaging, but I damage my hair anyway with heat every single day and all sorts of things, and with washing it too often and all that stuff. And so, you know, you kind of, you just have to, for me, it's like not that big of a deal. I just really wanted extensions, so I don't really care if my natural hair is that, like, a little damaged. There's lots of different types of permanent extensions you can get. You can get them braided in your hair. One of my friends last summer in New York had hers braided in. She had like 2 braids going across. You can get them like glued in by like wefts or taped in, where it's like long strands of hair like going across your head. There's lots of different kinds, but I researched it and I really wanted the strand by strand. It's like the most natural looking. Like, you really, I can't even tell where my natural hair is. And part of it was she styled it really well, but it's just, I don't know, I really like it. I'm very, very excited and pleased with the way it turned out. So to take care of it, she said to wash it not any more often than every 3 days, which before I was washing it every 2 days, so I'm going to have to extend it by a day, which kind of freaks me out. But she said when you curl it, the and I've actually found this out the last couple days, the curls stay a lot better than in your natural hair. I don't know what it is, because it's real human hair, but it just, like, I don't know if it's been processed in a certain way, but the curls stay longer. So you curl it on day one, and then day two, it's still kind of wavy and pretty. And then day three, you can just do something with it, like put in a clip or wear it in a braid or a ponytail. Just do something with it, and then you can wash it that night and curl it for the next day. So it really isn't that bad. It's actually easier to take care of than my real hair, because my real hair had a really awful texture and it was really hard to deal with, and it didn't hold curl like this hair does. When you buy the hair, it comes with a special boar bristle brush that you're supposed to use on it, and then it comes with the shampoo and conditioner you're supposed to use on it, which is sulfate free so that it doesn't mess up your bonds. And when you get out of the shower, you use a wide-toothed comb to comb through it, and then you can use your boar bristle brush once it's mostly dry, and you dry it, and then you can style it. Like, I use just a curling iron to do it. You don't need to use, I didn't use any hairspray or anything, because it just stays better than my real hair. Like, it's crazy. It's just better. I don't know. I love it. I know people are going to ask me about prices. They really differ on where you live in the country. If you're in LA or New York, they're going to be really, really expensive. And if you're in small town USA like I was, they're going to be a lot more doable. But they are very expensive. They're the most expensive type of extensions you can get. So I'm not going to quote you a price because it's really different at every salon. When you feel your hair, you can't feel them, which is great, because I had my mom like feel them when I first came home, and because I think she expected me to, like, when you have clip-ins, you can feel the clip-ins, like it's so bulky on your head. And with these, like, you can't, maybe if you know they're there and you dig your fingers into the back, you can feel them. But if someone's just like touching your hair or something, they're not going to be able to feel them, which I think's great. So she started at the bottom and she put them all the way up to this point. So like my ear, pretty much all my hair is in extensions. And then up here, there aren't any. Back through here, there aren't any. All through here. And then there's a little bit right in the front, like right here. There's a few staggered on both sides, like up to this point. But there's none back here, and she did that so that I can style it easier. I can put it in ponytails, I can do half ups, like I can do all sorts of things, and you won't be able to see the little bonds. And I don't wear my hair up ever. You guys know, like, you guys have seen my videos now for 2 years, and I never have. I maybe have had my hair up in like one or two videos total for 2 years. So I'm fine wearing it down, and I'm very excited about them. If anyone has any questions about them, you can leave me a comment below and I'll try to get back to you if I know the answer. But they're still fairly new to me, but I'm really excited about them. I love them. And I've wanted long hair forever. It's like princess hair. So it's very beachy. And I might get a cut just a little bit, like maybe an inch or two. She didn't want to cut too much because she was like, you know, you need to get used to it. You're not used to having hair this long. And if you still want me to cut an inch or two off in a week or so, you can. So we'll see. Sorry for the lack of videos lately. I will try to be good. I'm going to try to film a To the Beach Haul collection video next, if I have enough time before dinner, so that I have another one to put up. So I'll be wearing the same outfit probably in that one. Hope you guys are enjoying your summer so far, and let me know if you have any questions, and I will see you guys later. Bye. When you sleep at night, you're supposed to sleep in a long side braid so that it doesn't get tangled in your sleep. I slept in it in a side braid for the last couple days, and it kind of keeps your curl too, so that's good. So anyway, I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.